Welcome to Primary Mathematics 2022 Home Instructor Guide How To Part 3, where we're going to discuss opening your lesson successfully. I'm Jessica Kaminsky, one of the authors of the Home Instructor's Guide, and we've already talked about how to prepare for the chapter and be ready, but let's talk about how to make the most out of entering into this lesson and ensuring that your student activates prior knowledge while uses hands-on materials to build new knowledge based on the objective. So you're going to see in your home instructor's guide at the beginning of each lesson, you'll see the days recommended, and it's going to list your objective, your vocabulary, and your materials. A couple things to note. If you're doing kindergarten, you typically will see 1 to 2 days given for each lesson. Again, thinking about a day's lesson would be 30, 20 minutes, depending on your student. So this one lesson is 2 of those 30-minute sessions. If you're working within first grade through fifth grade, it's going to be a day. And that day could again be 30 to 55 minutes depending on your student. So just think about that as you're planning. I really want you to note the materials because you want to make sure that you have all those accessible for your lesson so that you're not hunting for them and you know where they are. Anything that says TR is a teacher resource. So you would find that with your online access code. It's a PDF, print that out and have it ready for your student. So we're always going to start with a focus question. This is to activate prior knowledge. Spend 1 to 2 minutes here and just ask your student, what do you know? What can you use to help you count? And maybe provide your student with some ideas or ask them to use materials and explain this to you. You're going to revisit this question, so it's okay if your student doesn't have this amazing answer, but it's just a way to open the lesson and to focus on where we're headed and to activate that prior knowledge. If you've seen anything from the Ministry of Education, Singapore's syllabus, you know that we're going to follow the phases of learning. We've talked about readiness when we looked at preparing for the chapter, and now we're entering into the engagement cycle. Students should be engaged, and they're going to use materials and conversation to get the most out of this lesson. So when we open a lesson in kindergarten, you'll see this amazing teacher tip in the home instructor's guide that's going to tell you that this task is going to include movement, concrete items, pictorial representation, and abstract representations. Now, this is based off of work from Jerome Bruner that we're working within that concrete pictorial abstract, and we're including some amazing movement. It tells you the task should take about 10 minutes. And that you may want to have a student recording journal. This does not have to be anything major. This could be a composition book. It could be a couple of sheets of paper stapled together, but just somewhere for your student to journal. Now, this is recommended in kindergarten. However, grades 1 through 5 would probably benefit from a journal as a place to record journal entries or just even some drawings or work as well. So keep that in mind. So you're going to start with your lesson opener. You'll see that it lists tasks there. And then you're going to walk through those components. You have a movement, a concrete, pictorial, and abstract representation that your student will engage in to really understand this concept. This one is counting and showing 1 and 2. And all these ways are going to help your student to solidify this concept. In grade 1 through 5, you're going to see kind of the same language here. It's going to ask you to possibly look at the bubble that you're going to see in the student book. It tends to look like this. And it wants you to cover the rest of the page so that your student isn't looking at that other stuff. I usually just take a sheet of paper and put it over there and we zoom in on that top section. Now you'll notice it'll ask you to use manipulatives. It'll tell you kind of just to allow your student to explore. Again, think 5 to 10 minutes here. This is not your lesson. This is that opener. It's the test to get your student thinking. And it's going to help your student to carry it over as you zoom into the objective, which is the next part of the lesson. Just a couple of components. Remember, you're thinking about a short span of time. So you want to make sure that your student uses concrete manipulatives. You want to encourage your student to problem solve. This is building that perseverance. So when they see the problem and your student may say, I don't know what to do, ask your student, is there anything in the picture that can help you solve this? What do you already know? Can you solve it in another way? And you're really just trying to encourage your student to think about this problem and to think about what he or she already knows and how that translates into this part of the task. As you move into the next part of the lesson where we're going to zoom in on the objective, you're going to connect this perseverance and this problem solving to what you're actually trying to teach in your lesson. So it's really important that your student starts off with this engaging task using materials and then solidifies it as we move into the next part, which is the objective. You can check out the next part of the lesson in part 4, where we're going to look how we connect this to that objective and see how we can help fine-tune students' understanding.